Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about the different basics of the refractive errors. As you all know that if the parallel rays of light coming from the infinity are focused back of the retina, this state of refraction is called hypermetropia. And if the light rays which are coming from the infinity are focused in front of the sensitive layer of the retina, this state of the refraction is called myopia. And if the light rays which are coming from the infinity are focused exactly on the sensitive layer of the retina, this condition is called emetropia for normal eye. In this video, we will discuss about the astigmatism and different types of the astigmatism on the basis of the location of the focal point. Now we will discuss about the three different types of the astigmatism. The first one is called simple astigmatism, second one is called compound astigmatism, and third one is called mixed astigmatism. So let's discuss. The very first is called simple hyperopic astigmatism. As you can see, the different light rays, when penetrate the eye, some of the light rays are focused on the sensitive layer of the retina and some of the light rays are focused back of the retina or behind the retina. So you can see there are two different focal points. The first one is on the retina and second one is behind the retina. So this is called simple hyperopic astigmatism. And if we talk about the simple myopic astigmatism, there are two different focal points. The first focal point is in front of the retina and the second one is on the sensitive layer of the retina, and this is called simple myopic astigmatism. And now we will discuss about the compound myopic astigmatism. And as you can see that both of the focal points are focused in front of the retina but at the different positions. So this is called compound myopic astigmatism. And now compound hyperopic astigmatism. As you can see that both of the focal points of the light rays are focused back of the retina or behind the retina but at different positions. So this is called compound hyperopic astigmatism. Now we will discuss about the mixed astigmatism. In mixed astigmatism, you can see that there are two focal points. The first one is focused in front of the retina and the second one is focused behind the retina. Now we will verify the astigmatic prescription. We have a toric prescription here with plus 2 sphere and minus 1 cylinder. If you find any prescription like this which have same power of sphere and cylinder but with opposite signs, then we have to transpose it, right? And this prescription is called simple astigmatism. So let me transpose it. The spherical would be 0. Cylinder would be in plus sign with axis 90 apart, and this prescription would be now we have another example of the toric prescription. We have plus 2 sphere with minus 1 cylinder at 90 degree, and we have spherical correction greater than the cylindrical correction, as you can see here, but with the opposite sign. We have plus 2 spherical greater than minus 1 cylinder with opposite sign. If you find any prescription like this, this is called compound astigmatism, and we have to transpose it. After transposition, we will find plus 1 sphere with plus 1 cylinder at 180 degree. As you can see that this is called compound hyperopic astigmatism. And if you find out whether the prescription is compound hyperopic astigmatism or compound myopic astigmatism, this thing depends on the sign of the spherical correction. So we have plus sphere and our prescription after transposition is compound hyperopic astigmatism, and if we got minus 2 or minus sign with the sphere, then our prescription would be in myopic compound astigmatism. In this example, we have spherical greater or lesser than the cylinder. If we have any prescription like in which the spherical correction is greater or lesser than the cylinder with the same sign, then this prescription would be compound astigmatism, and there is no any need to transpose or change the prescription. In the first prescription, we have spherical correction, which is greater than the cylindrical correction at 90 degree. So there is no any need to change this prescription, and this prescription would be compound astigmatism. And in the next example, we have lesser spherical correction and greater cylindrical correction at 180 degree. So there is no any need to change or transpose this prescription, and this prescription would be the same compound astigmatism. Now we have the final example in which the spherical correction is lesser than the cylindrical correction with the opposite sign. So in this condition, if you find any prescription like this, there is no any need to transpose this prescription. This prescription is simply mixed astigmatism.